Hey everyone, today we'll be talking about Rust's Iterator Collect. When dealing with streaming data, it's common to gather incoming items into a collection, so you can operate on it later. For example, you may be writing a parser, have a stream of tokens you later assemble to an AST, or perhaps you're iterating over lines in CSV values, and want to store each line as an entry in the database so it can be queried later. The base shape of this is to iterate over each item in the iterator and write the output to a collection. For example here, we iterate over each item in input using a for loop and store it in an output vector. However, this is not as efficient as it could be. Each time we're pushing an item into the vector, we need to perform a new allocation. Instead, it's far better if we can reserve memory upfront and then write to it later. Iterators provide a sizehint method, which can tell us how many items are likely to be in the iterator. Though it's not easy to use. So what if there was a simpler way? This is what the iterator collect method is for. It allows us to take an iterator and convert it into some output. Before we had a manual loop, it was four lines of code, and we were iterating over every item in a step, and we had to pre-allocate everything. Instead, what we're doing here is we're converting our input into an iterator, we're calling collect on it, and that collects it into an output. Collect is based on two traits, iterator and from iterator. The from iterator trait can create a new instance of a type by consuming an iterator. Examples that implement from iterator are vec and hashmap. But we don't need to use the collect method per se. We can also call the from iterator trait on any type that implements it and pass in iterator directly. The benefit of calling collect is that we can just write it in the chain fashion instead, which is both easier to read and write. Finally, if instead of initializing a new type, you want to add items to an existing type, you can use the extend method instead. This is implemented through the extend trait, which exists on all the same types in the standard lib as from iterator. So to summarize, collect is a really nice way to go from an iterator to a collection. The way this is implemented is only possible with ML-style type systems like Rust has, and is a great example of how expressive Rust can be.